It's so nice to just talk a little, you and I. I was just thinking, would you be interested if I told you a little about myself?
Actually, that's something I'd like to ask you instead. Am I a burden to you? I mean, do you find me useful? Do you enjoy my company?
Oh no! I'm devastated. I thought at least I was of some use.
Maybe we should part ways then. I definitely don't want to be a burden.
I think there's a dialogue where you can actually tell her we're splitting up for good, and then she actually leaves the game and you don't see her again. I think I tried that one time. It's kind of cool. I know Rigmor does that too. She'll leave the game if you say a certain thing to her. But yeah, so that last scene with Vilya there, I don't want that conversation to come up if I'm playing a female character. So I'm hoping she detects if you're female or not in the game and doesn't push the whole marriage thing on you. I don't remember what happened last time I used Vilya when I was playing a female.
We could always use help picking crops if you need a few extra coins. Honest pay for honest work. Honest pay for honest work. May your path be free from danger.
Anyway, she and her husband are alive only because I have Protect Your People installed. That's otherwise they'd be dead long time ago. They'd be dead. You know, wolves or bears or werewolves or dragons would have killed them off so long ago. By the time you go over here to visit the farm, there's no one to talk to or no quests to get from anyone because they're long dead. But Protect Your People makes all the NPCs protected, so only you can kill them. No one else can. They're still killable. Just only you get to kill them. Otherwise, you have to have mods like, you know, run for cover, run for your very lives, you know, that kind of thing. But who has time to make mods to cover every single NPC in the game? Make sure they run indoors somewhere. I mean, the person making Immersive Citizen AI Overhaul, they're trying their best to make every house in the game a safe house for NPCs to run into.
Climb and back, and we'll be off.
But it's just one person doing that project.
Wouldn't it be nice to just talk a little, you and I?
Oh, I like how she waits till I'm on the carriage.
Firebeard seems to be very protective towards Jarl Elisif, doesn't he?
Who is the Blade
with
this?
Just yesterday I saw a musician in the street playing a flute. It was beautiful. I want that flute.
What? I don't remember her saying that before.
Dorian is helping me perfect my fencing, but I don't think I'll ever be as good as he is. Need something?
We have to be at the same eye level to hug? Oh, can she hug me now? Oh, there she goes. Oh, that would have been cool if it started a quest where I have to go beat up somebody and take their flute from them.
These vampires are becoming a real menace.
Well, they're becoming a headache for me because I can't find them. Every time I look
the
for them,
Imperials think us all lawless beasts.
I don't see them.
I'm proof of their ignorance. As if Skyrim didn't have enough outsiders. Now we've got mercenaries from Hammerfell strutting about.
And since I joined the vampires, I don't get that traveler dude in my game. He hasn't shown up one time in this playthrough. Maybe he showed up once, but the moment I joined up with Harkon, That was it. No more travelers coming into my town. Just regular vampires show up, but not the traveler dude.
Oh, what happened?
Ah, dead body!
Yeah, that's been there for a week now. It's starting to smell. So we're collecting these bard chant things for Vilya. Uh-oh. Got some guards watching me.
Wouldn't it be nice to just talk a little, you and I? How do you feel about thievery? Yes, of course. I'm proud of you for being such a righteous person. Still, I can understand if the poor beggars are tempted to pickpocket wealthier citizens. You know, I think we should give them a coin more often.
Talk later.
So my next playthrough, I think I'll just skip over all of Vilya's quests. And tell her that we're not lifelong friends.
A good story is nine parts truth.
She'll already be omnipotent before I even meet her, kind of thing.
Can we really just make things up?
Not sure if that's even possible, though.
Read carefully. You will see there are ways to stay true to the essence.
Welcome to the Bard's College. It's such a pleasure to see you again. Ah, the last book of chants. I hope it was not too awkward to track it down. The college has decided that on top of your reward, we also want to give you a special gift to show our appreciation. I hope you like poetry. As for Vilya, she is now worthy to join the college and is thereby a certified bard.
But me?
It won't make any huge difference for the two of you, of course, but it may be that she will later be appointed to perform at certain events. And if you're looking for further ways to help the college, I already have some tasks that need to be done. As for the chance...
I don't think I'm a bard yet. So I keep waiting for him to say something about it.
I have evaluated and written down my conclusions from the first three books of chance that you have brought me. You should give the book to Vilya, and I'm sure that you will be able to learn some of the simpler chants. As for the fourth book of chants, I have understood that it will only contain chants on a level that is, well, way beyond what Vilya can handle. But who knows? If the two of you continue to do tasks for the college, he might find further chants that she could learn to use. So, this book is for her. Give it to her, and I'm sure it will be useful for both of you. Again, many thanks for your help. I hope we will meet soon again. As Vilya now has joined our college, it's a pity that you have not. Of course, as a bard, you would need to be able to play an instrument. At least I can help you with this. Here. I have a flute, a lute, and a drum for you.
Oh, he gave me these things.
If you practice, maybe you and Vilya could perform together. And if you were a college member, I could even assign performances to the two of you. Have you considered joining us? If so, you should speak to Biarmo. I've heard that he has some tasks that need to be handled. Once you have been accepted as a member by him, return to me and I will assign the two of you a performance. Make sure that you bring your music instruments.
So I've already got one of each, and then he gave
one
me...
One of our bards ran into an awkward situation.
So now I have two of each.
On his way to Solitude, he got so scared by a giant that he dropped his music instrument and ran away. When he later returned, the music instrument was gone. I assume that the giant has taken it. I'll mark the giant's camp on the map for you. If you could get the music instrument back, the college will of course reward you.
if you are to retrieve music instruments from a giant's camp,
goodbye.
You better be sneaking. I wouldn't want to make a giant angry. They can be pretty deadly.
And then the reason why Vilya's been acting that way. I've been slowly removing and adding different sex lab mods.
No, I don't give private lessons. Glad that distraction's Billy, over.
What year did the Aldmeri Dominion
seeing if phone.
Late 171.
If the scripts will clog or not.
Yorn, what happened during the Red Year?
I have faith that you'll return with King Olaf.
So far, the only mod I can't really use is Lover's Victim. That mod stops working. Because I think it conflicts with something else I'm using. So you end up with a bunch of NPCs standing around, staring at each other. One of these years, if I remember, I'll turn on the logging and then look at the logs of the game and see what Lover's Victim is doing or not doing. And the other thing I want to do is marry a character before I quit this playthrough. Just to see if marriage works in the game. Usually what I'll do is I'll marry somebody and then quickly divorce them. And then marry somebody else. Just to see what that does. If it adds to the game or not. If you have divorced characters in the game. Chance.
I must admit that I would never have managed to accomplish this on my own. Don't be silly. Of course you had a choice. And you chose the right thing. I'm truly so grateful. Finally I can call myself a bard. A real bard. It would be really interesting to study the chants that Wilbert put together for me, but I guess it would take a little while before I can use them. I start to study them at once, and then I tell you when I'm confident enough. So, where are we going now? Smells like garlic.
Ripped out like that.
Meanwhile, Mirak is absorbing my dragon souls.
I grow ever.
Bastard.
What was that?
So another thing I did is I installed the Mirak follower. So it's good that he showed up to absorb the dragon soul. That way I know he's not broken if he's able to do that still in the game. Because I had the mod patched because I have a Mirak overhaul mod installed, so it
No!
It gives Mirak a face and a body. So he's not just a suit. Because you know how the first gen mods were for followers? They were always
say that it's
a character covered from head to toe in armor, so you
but
never saw their face.
He's fine now. That's not bad, is it?
Because modders didn't know yet how to make custom bodies yet.
Problem for you. Thank you. That's really sweet of you. What's on your mind, friend?
Now it seems like everyone but me knows how to make an NPC. I mean, I can make an NPC of my own and put it on Nexus. I just have to sit down and do it. That's all. There's plenty of YouTube videos out there showing how it's done. Looks easy enough. I just have to sit down and be good at making a head.
Yes?
Because that's how you make one, you make a character that's you, and then you save your character and turn and then convert it into an NPC.
Wow, what was that? Do it again!
A Nordic ruin. What say you? Should we investigate?
Then once you have an NPC saved, that would be your template, and you just use that to make other NPCs, and you just keep saving under a different name. So each NPC has the same file structure, just a different file name. You know, different skin textures, hairstyles, that kind of thing. And just use assets that are in the game. Tell the people downloading your mod what mods are required to use the NPCs. Like, do you need the Apache hair? You know, that kind of thing. Do you need a certain armor installed? Otherwise, the NPCs are going to be naked in the game.
What was that?
That looks like a door right there. Oh, is Braith broken? She wasn't holding her weapon. She's just kind of standing there. Maybe she was bleeding out or something. When she got back up, she's not able to equip a weapon. She'll figure it out. I guess my followers aren't following me? Is that what's going on? Or they just can't get to me from this maze we're in.
I'm not afraid of smoke. You'll be so dead. You leave my friend alone, bastard!
Huh? That was kind of neat. She got some wax in there, and he wouldn't die. Oh, that was close. One of my companions was, like, trapped in here. Oh, there they are. Nope.
Why are you looking at me like that?
Where are they? Was it Braith we were looking for? Yeah, there's Braith. What is she doing? She's just standing there? Or is it someone else? What are you doing?
Hmm?
Yeah, she's broken. She coming? No. Why isn't she moving? I don't remember what I did to make her move.
Wow, what was that? Do it again.
Meanwhile, I'm stepping on booby traps. Are you coming? Do I have to do the old trick of unfollowing you and then refollow you?
Until next time.
Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna make her a follower again.
Good to see you. Ooh, wonderful. I can't wait.
Let go of the camera. Oh, she's coming now. Okay. I didn't know kids suffer from that too. They get jammed up, and the only way to unjam them is to unfollow them and then refollow them. Usually on the internet, people say, "Why don't you just disable and enable the person?" No, that's not what you do. It's never ever worked for me. Other people say, "Why don't you just hit them with your sword?" That usually fixes them. Whatever. Who's playing Skyrim and spending most of their time whacking their NPCs like a whack-a-mole? That's something the Three Stooges do. They would always hit each other. Remember, they'd always, like, one guy would always grab a saw and rub it across someone's chin. Try to cut his jaw off. Or poke the other guy's eyeballs out with their finger. Or grab the guy by the nostrils and lead him around the place.
What was that?
If you have to do that to your NPCs in Skyrim, then you're not playing Skyrim, you're playing something else. I hate to say. So we've already been in this whole area here. Is that a door we haven't been through yet? I can't remember.
I'm not afraid of you.
I still don't know how my shield works. Somehow I'm able to slow time down, but I don't know what good that is if I'm slowed down too. So I don't get it. Maybe I'm just doing it wrong. Or I got mods that are interfering with how another mod is supposed to work. Because that's a mod that does that with the shield. There's nothing in vanilla that makes time slow down just by hitting that shield. So far they're catching up with me. And this is the one time I use the whirlwind sprint or whatever it's called. I almost never do that. Usually I just run through. Totally forget that I have a sprint shout of some kind. Vilya doesn't suffer from a broken spine like she did in my last playthrough. That was getting on my nerves. Her waist would be bent. 100 degrees in the wrong direction. I like how Braith is being a good little soldier. She's got her lantern lighting up the way. It's kind of cool.
Some men just don't know when it's time to give up.
And sometimes she does the death blows, like the last killer move. I'm about ready to kill something and she'll ninja in front of me and kill whatever it is I'm about ready to swing at. I like when you can just knock down a Draugr before it fully awakes and comes after you. Oh, great. that guy again? So many problems with this quest. Things weren't triggering right. You know, the bad guy you're supposed to kill. Olaf! You know, that guy. He spawns outside of his sarcophagus. That's a no-no. He's supposed to burst out of the thing. Uh-oh. I'm saying how great Braith is, and here she is bleeding out. She's easy to heal because she's only level 1, I think. She doesn't have much buffer of health to refill. Everyone around here is preparing for the hurricane that's going to hit Baja California. I think it's going to turn into a tropical storm, like it usually does, but at least near California. But it's weird how Hurricane Rosa, it's like a repeat of the last Hurricane Rosa. I didn't know they reused names for hurricanes, but I guess they do. Oh, there he is. Oh, okay, yeah, so I did record some of it. This part was all glitched. We come in here and the fight scene is just, it's all messed up. Then someone on the internet said, hey, how come some of the stones are darker than some of the other stones? And so I had to go look around, and sure enough, some of the stones are darker than some of the other stones. The guy who's been retexturing Nordic ruins, I guess he missed a few places. So he provided a little patch to fix those issues, and I downloaded the patch, and when I came back into the game, I didn't notice any difference. Not much of a patch, if you ask me. So anyway. Where was I? I was supposed to be, opening this portal thing. Okay, my followers are typical followers, as you can tell. Everyday followers you would have in your Skyrim default game. After adding 200 mods to your configuration. The ruby. It's the ruby one? I don't get to use this craw too often. What the heck's on it? I can barely tell. Dragons? I think my lantern's brighter than Brace because I'm just bigger than her. So it scales out farther than hers does. She has this little itty bitty lantern, and I got this big lantern. It'd be cool if the lantern stayed the same size no matter who you gave it to. Okay, now we're in the place where the bugs happened.
Olaf, it is his time.
I think part of the problem is the Dawnbreaker. I guess Dawnbreaker triggered one of the Draugr to come out of the case too soon, and it broke the whole quest. The bard is just standing there. So they're only attacking him, not me, you know, that kind of thing. So that we try again.
Olaf, it is time.
Because he's supposed to say the next thing and the next thing. Because you're his follower. And if he gets jammed, then you're like, okay, what's the next step of this quest? What do we do next in the dungeon crawl? I don't remember if I picked a different weapon to use. Or if I kept... Oh. You guys, get in here. Get in here. Get in the dungeon. Okay, where's the music? There's no music? See, now the bard's just kind of standing there.
Now I'm gonna get you. Don't you eat
it. You must. So his quest could have broke before we even came in this room.
You're a bastard, aren't you? Now I'm gonna get my kill.
Whoa. So they're just beating on the guy repeatedly. He's not dying or nothing. He's not scheduled. He's not supposed to. Uh-oh. He's having sex with somebody.
Come on, show me how brave you are.
So, sound effects and everything are happening out of order. The guy's just sitting there. He's like, when will this get over with? We have to have our last battle. so the bard can do his song and dance at the end of the quest. And there's King Olaf here. He's outside the box. Why is he outside the box?
You will be so dead.
Try again.
My vengeance is at hand.
Okay, so now we reached. This is the next boss fight? Yeah. This is part two. Part two of the fight. So things spawned when they're supposed to have. Oh, this is weird. I have no shouts? What? What? I've never seen that before. Was I sprayed with something that prevents me from using a shout? Maybe it just wore off. Maybe it was one of those 2 second things I was hit with. Oh, okay, that's better. Now everything's back. Took 4 people to kill that crazy skeleton woman. Okay, this is the final third silent. That's what's supposed to happen. Let's finish this. Man, he didn't last long. He seemed a bit nerfed to me. He should have been a tough boss, but nope, he was just a regular dude. Okay, now the bard can go sing and dance over in the corner there. Okay. Taking forever to get through this. Yeah, I had to go back a previous save and come re-enter the room later on so this place could initialize in the proper fashion. Isn't there a chest around here somewhere? Or maybe I've already gone through the chest. One of the mods I had makes all these skeletons get up and come after you. I think it was immersive creatures. So there's nothing left standing, or nothing left sitting? Yeah. There's nothing left sitting when this fight is over. I can't move. Take something.
Yes, sir.
Do I want that? I think we already have something like it. Oh, here's a chest. So a few videos ago, yeah, I was doing live streams, basically just to try out my mod list, see if I can get the game to crash, and I could not get my Skyrim to crash whatsoever. So I was shocked.